slide. That's my father at the piano. And as you can see, originally this was out here, and I'm experimenting with cutting it and moving it in. I'm curious to see what it would be like if it were a square image. So I've added this on, and this is now 9.5 inches, so I'm going to be going down here and doing 9.5 inches that way, and then doing some drawing underneath here to see. Here's his knee. Here. He's sort of walking forward. So this leg is probably coming back like that. So his pant leg is coming down. This one is going like that. So his foot is somewhere around here. As you can see, I'm starting to actually physically cut this thing out and rearrange it. And I know this is the kind of thing that usually people do with Photoshop nowadays, but there's something much simpler about this for me. There's something nice about when you're working with physical materials rather than electronic materials, to kind of work with physical materials too. And so I'm starting to actually cut things out. This is much more altered than they usually are. Usually take things pretty much exactly how I find them, but sometimes things just need a little bit of work. This one is a good example. I really worked a lot with altering that composition, but I just keep finding that it's just so perfect the way it is. It's just so awesome that I just kind of can't see changing it. I love to work with images as I find them when I can, and this one has got so many great elements in it, but it just needs a little bit of work on the composition. So now I've, with my decidedly low-tech way, literally taken this woman and cut her out and just moved her this way and moved everything this way. Now I'm going to apply a little bit of paint to this paper down here, see if I can get some darks and lights, and see if I still like the composition. I'm also wondering about this. This is the back of a chair I remember from my childhood, but it's visually confusing. It's hard to see exactly what it is, so I'm not sure whether or not I'm going to keep that in there. So as you can see now, I have done some painting here and did some very rough sketches here. Here I covered up that with a little painting there. I moved her over here and drew some legs down and imagined what this was, which is a table in the foreground. And now, one of the things that I frequently do is I actually come up to a mirror and I look at it backwards to see what it looks like in terms of just its abstract composition. And then another thing that I will often do is turn it upside down, hang it on the wall, turn it upside down, and see what it looks like just in terms of like color and dark and light, and see if it's interesting.
Five cabin on an 85 hill. Hang on, St. Chris. I know my baby is gonna jump and shout. I know my baby girl is gonna jump and shout. When the train rolls up and I come walking out, hold out, baby, I'll be home one day. Hold out, baby, I'll be home one day. Please don't let nobody lead my little girl astray. Well, baby, girl, you know that I love you, my little baby. You know that I love you, because you can take me low down and dirty, then I'll come right back and worry you.
Spraying, rubbing alcohol on it, and then going at it with a single-edged razor blade to just take off that layer of paint and leave just like a ghost. I'm kind of going to almost like start over with this because it was just looking a little too tight and looking a little too, I don't know, just not good enough. So it's painful, but sometimes that's what you have to do.
this is goodbye.